gonna take a shot from five different places, and I'm gonna make a shot 5 times in a row. I can make it 5 times in a row. Yeah, got it.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Ah, that's good.
I'm so excited.
Do you like Korean food?
Yes.
Ah, that's good. I really like it too.
This is the beginning of the day when they wake up, right? So we need three rooms for this.
Without any sound.
With any sound, you get out of the bed. Yeah. You, no, first of all, you put all your stuff.
Yeah,
me too.
Yes.
I'm not late. The time is early.
Oh, teacher. My life is a movie. I'm a star.
Somewhere you can tell me. He walks on, doesn't look back. He pretends he can't hear her.
For the past 33 years, I have looked in the mirror every morning and asked myself, if today were the last day of my life, would I want to do what I am about to do today? And whenever the answer has been no for too many days in a row, I know I need to change something. Remembering that I'll be dead soon is the most important tool I've ever encountered to help me make the big choices in life. Because almost everything, all external expectations, all pride, all fear of embarrassment or failure, these things just fall away in the face of death, leaving only what is truly important.
I don't want to do anything, just talk with my family and say I love them, all of the things.
I will eat the very delicious food. I will go to the restaurant with friends and talk with very funny stories with them. And I will try to be happy in the end of the life.
I wanna see my family and friends.
Call my mother, and I will never tell her, but I will talk to her until last minute or last second.
What would I do? One of the first things you'd have to do would be to discover why was it the last day of your life. I would think you would want to know why.
Remembering that you are going to die is the best way I know to avoid the trap of thinking you have something to lose. You are already naked. There is no reason not to follow your heart.